Hey guys, welcome back to Homebrew India. If you're new here, thank you for coming, and if you would like to learn more about brewing and fermenting stuff, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the notification bell so that you don't miss out on the new recipes which are coming up soon. So today we're gonna make wine from a berry which probably you haven't heard of, or maybe you have. Falsa berry. So today we will be making wine with falsa berry. If you don't know what falsa berry is, falsa berries are the small round shaped berries which generally comes in summer season, and they are sweet and sour in taste, and they have a fantastic color. It's maroonish, rich maroon color. So without any further ado, let's just start with the video. The links to all the equipments that I have used in this video are in the description below, so you can check them out. Today I want to make a liter of this wine, not more, and for that I have 1.5 kilos of falsa berries. I've put them in a Ziploc bag and will freeze them overnight. Remember I froze mango for mango cider? Similarly, this way the sugars and the taste extracted will be much better. Ziploc bags and everything ahead were sanitized. Refer to the sanitization video so that you don't end up getting bacteria or mold in your wine. Fermentation is a hard work and I wouldn't want your hard work go down the drain. Click on the I button after this video to have a look. So it's been quite some time now and the bags are out of the deep freezer. We have to squish the berries. I suggest you simply press on the berries in the bag itself so that it starts to release its juice. Once all of it is squished, then simply take it out in a bowl. I highly recommend you to squeeze out the juice from the pulp right now. I'll show you my mistake ahead. I have put all the pulp in the demijohn and added 450 grams of sugar. You should add just about the same quantity of sugar in the juice. If the total amount of your juice is less than 1 liter, just top it up with some water until it hits the 1 liter spot, then mix it well. This is a 2.5 liters demijohn, so don't get confused with the quantity right now with the pulp and the quantity after I strain the pulp out. I had to pitch the yeast directly into the demijohn without making any yeast starter. You could make a yeast starter by pitching a teaspoon of active dried yeast into some juice. Yeast starter is not necessary, but it just gives us an idea of how active our yeast is. It works just the same. The original gravity was 1.100 for it. If you don't understand what I just said, I suggest you to watch my gravity reading video after this video. You can find the link to it by clicking on the I button now. Let's put the airlock now and let the yeast do its magic. So guys, as I was talking about my mistake earlier in this video, here it is. I had put the pulp and filled it almost up to the top. Yes, it over fermented and I had to do some cleaning. Please completely avoid using pulp, just use juice. Luckily, I did not have a lot of wastage and I was still left with most of my wine. I just filtered it through a sieve and put it back again for fermentation. After 4 days, the fermentation was done. The final gravity was 1.010, giving us an alcohol content of 11.81%. A superb work done by our bread yeast. I'll bottle my falsa berry wine and after that we'll give it a taste. So guys, here we are for the tasting, and as you can see, the color of this wine is amazing. It is actually amazing. I mean, I haven't had any better colored wines at home. So now I will just give it a smell. Nothing fancy, just a bit of sweetness and a lot of falsa punch in the face. So the taste of falsa, if you don't know, is sweet and sour. That's what the taste I get from the wine as well. It's quite sour. It has the whole flavor of falsa. Really nice. I suggest you should give it a try at least once. So guys, this was falsa berry. I hope you liked it as much as I did, and I would love to see you make at home. If you like the video, please give me a like and don't forget to subscribe to the channel.